Hi students, in the last section we have studied what is a polynomial, types of polynomials, that is linear, quadratic, cubic, biquadratic, etc. How to find zero of a linear polynomial and how to find the zero or zeros of a linear as well as quadratic polynomials, isn't it? കഴിഞ്ഞ ക്ലാസ്സുകളിലായി എന്താണ് ഈ പോളിനോമിയലുകൾ എന്നും ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് പോളിനോമിയലുകളെ കുറിച്ചും പോളിനോമിയലുകളുടെ സീറോ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സീറോസിനെ കുറിച്ചും ഒരു ലീനിയർ പോളിനോമിയലിൻ്റെ സീറോ കാണുന്ന രീതി, ഒരു ഗ്രാഫ് തന്നിരുന്നാൽ അതിൽ എത്ര സീറോ ഉണ്ട്, നമ്പർ ഓഫ് സീറോസ് അല്ലെങ്കിൽ സീറോസ് ആരൊക്കെയാണ് എന്നൊക്കെ കണ്ടുപിടിക്കാനായിട്ട് പഠിച്ചു കഴിഞ്ഞു. ഇൻ ദിസ് ക്ലാസ് വി ഹാവ് സ്റ്റഡീഡ് വട്ട് ഈസ് ദ റിലേഷൻ ബിറ്റ്വീൻ സീറോ ആൻഡ് കോഎഫിഷ്യൻസ് ഓഫ് എ പോളിനോമിയൽ. ലെറ്റ് അസ് ടേക്ക് എ ക്വാഡ്രാറ്റിക് പോളിനോമിയൽ എ എക്സ് സ്ക്വയർ പ്ലസ് ബി എക്സ് പ്ലസ് സി ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ബി റെക്കഗ്നൈസ്ഡ് k into x minus alpha into x minus beta, where k be any constant, where k be any constant, isn't it? Now, it can recognize k into x into x, x square. Now x beta minus beta x minus alpha x and minus and minus plus alpha beta, isn't it? And I am writing this as kx square. If we take minus x outside, that is minus kx into beta plus alpha plus alpha beta. Once again, kx square minus alpha plus beta, beta plus alpha is same as alpha plus beta, into kx plus k into alpha beta. Here now k into alpha beta. So here it becomes k into alpha beta. This is kx square plus bx plus c. Now taking coefficients of x square, coefficients of x and the constant term, comparing or equating the coefficients of x square, x and the constant terms. We have, what is the coefficient of x square here? K. Here is A. That is A is equal to K, isn't it? X square, the coefficient of x square here is A. Here the coefficient of x square is K. So A is equal to K. Now coefficient of x here is B. Here coefficient of x is minus of alpha plus beta into K. Minus of alpha plus beta into K. Now we take the constant term, that is c. Here the constant is c. Here the constant is k into alpha beta. Alpha beta is a constant, it is also a constant. K into alpha beta, isn't it? If alpha and beta are rows, alpha and beta are the rows, then sum of the roots alpha plus beta is equal to sum of roots not roots, zeros. If alpha and beta are the zeros of the polynomial a x square plus bx plus c, then sum of zeros is alpha plus beta. Here we can equate these two, minus of alpha plus beta into k divided by k is equal to b by a. To find the sum of zeros, we take these two equations, minus of alpha plus beta into k divided by k is equal to b by a, isn't it? And k and k get cancelled. Minus of alpha plus beta is equal to b by a. Therefore, alpha plus beta is equal to minus of b by a. Sum of zeros is minus b by a. Minus b by a can be written as minus 1 into coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. Minus 1 into coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square is sum of zeros, which is minus b by a, isn't it? Now we are going to find product of zeros. Product of zeros. To find the product of zeros, we are comparing these two relations. That is, k alpha beta divided by k is equal to k alpha beta divided by k is equal to here c divided by k. Therefore, alpha beta is equal to c by a. Alpha beta is equal to c by a. That is, product of zeros is c by a. What about c? C is constant term. Constant term divided by coefficient of x square. This is alpha beta, product of zeros. Sum of zeros is in the quadratic polynomial ax square plus bx plus c. Sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, that is minus 1 into coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. And product of zeros alpha beta is equal to c by a. C is constant term divided by coefficient of x square, isn't it? Now let us take some examples. Find sum and product of zeros of the polynomials as question is today p of x is equal to 2x square minus 4x plus 6. Here k is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 4, c is equal to 6, isn't it? Now sum of zeros alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, that is minus b is minus 4 divided by 2. Minus into minus becomes plus 4 by 2, that is 2. This is sum of zeros. Now product of zeros alpha beta is equal to c by a. Here c is 6 divided by 2, that is 3. The sum of zeros and product of zeros of this polynomial, isn't it? Now let us take another question. Q of x is equal to x square minus 5x plus 4. Here a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 5, or c is equal to 4. So sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, minus 5 by 1, that is 5 by 1, that is 5. Sum of zeros is 5. And product of zero alpha beta is equal to c by a. Here c is 4 by 1, that is 4. Sum of zeros and product of zeros. ഒരു പോളിനോമിയലിന്റെ സം ഓഫ് സീറോസും പ്രോഡക്റ്റ് ഓഫ് സീറോസും കാണാനായിട്ട് ആ പോളിനോമിയലിനെ പോളിനോമിയലിൽ നിന്ന് എയും ബിയും സിയും കണ്ടുപിടിക്കുക. ആൽഫ പ്ലസ് ബീറ്റ മൈനസ് ബി ബൈ എ ആണ്, അതിന്റെ വാല്യൂ theta c by a constant term divided by coefficient of x square term, that is a product of zeros, isn't it? Next question is p of x half is equal to 2x square minus 8x plus 6. Here a is equal to b is equal to minus 8 and c is equal to 6. Now sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, that is minus of minus 8 divided by 2, that is 8 by 2 is equal to 4, and product of zeros alpha beta is equal, product of zero alpha beta is equal to c by a. Here c is 6 by 2, that is 3. Sum of zeros is 4 and product of zeros is 3. Now we are going to find the relationship between the zeros and the coefficients. Relation between zeros and coefficients. Let us illustrate it with an example. That p of x of is equal to x square plus 7x plus 6. We can find the zeros of this polynomial. That is, sum is equal to 7, coefficient of x. This is coefficient of x. Product term is equal to constant term 6, constant term. Now we are finding the factors of 6. What are the factors? 1 into 6, 2 into 3. Of these factors, 1 plus 6 is 7, 1 into 6 is 6. This is that. 2 plus 3, 5. We need 7. 2 minus 3 is minus 1. So it cannot be taken. Of the factors, only one factor will be satisfied. So 1 plus 6 is 7. Here we have 7. 1 into 6 is 6. The product is also same. So we can factorize this polynomial as write x, a shortcut method. Write x. Write the first factor. First factor is 1. Its sign is positive, so plus 1. Again, write x. Write the second factor. Here the second factor is 6, that is also positive. So plus 6. This is the factors of this polynomial. The normal hierarchy is p of x is equal to x square plus 7x plus 6. So we split the middle term into these two numbers, that is x square plus 1x plus 6x plus 6. From these two terms, we can take one x into, then x plus 1. From these two terms, one 6 can be taken, x plus 1. Now x plus 1 is common, so take x plus 1 outside. If we take x plus 1 here, then x is here, plus. If we take x plus 1 here, we have 6. So the product of, so the polynomial p of x is x plus 1 into x plus 6. These two steps can be neglected if you use this idea. Okay. To find the zeros of this polynomial, to find zeros, put p of x is equal to 0. How can we find zeros of the polynomial? We equate the polynomial into 0. So x plus 1 into x plus 6 is equal to 0, which implies that x plus 1 is equal to 0 or x plus 6 is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to minus 1 or x is equal to minus 6. These are the zeros of this polynomial. X is equal to minus 1 and x is equal to minus 6. Isn't it? Now, let me take first x is alpha. Let alpha is equal to minus 1 and beta is equal to minus 6. Alpha is minus 1 and beta is minus 6. Now we are going to find the relation between the zeros and coefficients. Now alpha plus beta. Now alpha plus beta is equal to minus 1 plus minus 6, that is minus 7. Minus 7 can be written as minus 7 by 1. That is minus 1 into 7 by 1. Here the coefficients of p of x, we have a is equal to a is equal to 1. What about b? B is equal to 7 and c is equal to 6. According to this polynomial, a is equal to 1, b is equal to 7 and c is equal to 6. Minus 1 into 7, 7 is b, that is minus b, 7 is b, divided by 1 is a. So alpha plus beta is alpha and beta, we have minus 7 plus minus 6, minus 7. Minus 7 can be written as minus 7 by 1, minus 1 into 7 by 1, that is minus 7 is b by a, minus b by a, that is minus 1 in the coefficient of x divided by the coefficient of x square, isn't it? This is the relation between zeros, and coefficients. Here, this is minus 1 into coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. But this is negative. Okay. Now let us discuss another example. P of x is equal to x square minus 5. P of x is equal to 0, which implies that x square minus 5 is equal to 0. Therefore, x square is equal to 5. Therefore, x is equal to plus or minus root of 5. Plus or minus root of 5. Therefore, alpha is equal to, alpha is plus or root of 5. Beta is equal to minus root of 5. Alpha is equal to root 5 and beta is equal to minus root 5. Now we are going to find sum of zeros. Alpha plus beta is equal to sum of zeros is root 5 plus minus root 5, that is 0. And 0 can be written as 0 divided by 1, that is equal to minus 1 into 0 divided by 1, that is minus 1 into coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square. Polynomial x square minus 5 can be written as x square minus 0x plus minus 5, that is minus 1. That is minus 1 into 0 is coefficient of x. Coefficient of x that divided by coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square is 1. The minus or plus both are same. 0 has no sign. So x square plus 0x plus minus 5. 0 by sum of zeros alpha plus beta is 0. 0 can be written as 0 by 1, 0 by any number is equal to 0. Minus 1 into 0 by 1, minus 1 into 0 is 0. 0 by 1 is again 0. That is minus 1 into coefficient of x by coefficient of x. Now find alpha beta. Alpha beta is e by alpha beta. Here alpha beta is what? Positive root 5 into negative root 5. That is root 5 in the root 5 is 5. X in the root x is x. Root x in the root x. Root x in the root x is equal to x. So root 5 in the root 5 is 5. Here we have minus 5. Root 5 in the root 5 is 5. And minus 5 can be written as minus 5 by 1. That is minus 5 is constant term. That is constant term divided by coefficient of x square, isn't it? This way we can find the relation between zeros and the coefficients. Can you follow this? Okay. Now let me take another example. P of x is equal to 2x square minus 8x plus 6. To find 0, put p of x is equal to 0. So 2x square minus 8x plus 6 is equal to 0. Dividing 2 by 2. Dividing by 2. So we have x square minus 4x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now sum of zeros, sum is equal to minus 4 and product is equal to 3. Sum is minus 4, coefficient of x is sum and product is constant and that is 3. Now find the factor of 3, factors of 3, 1 into 3. 3 is a prime number. So it has only two factors, 1 and 3, that number and 1. Now minus 1 plus minus 3, that is minus 4. Minus 1 into minus 3, that is 3. Minus 1 plus minus 3, minus 4. Minus 1 into minus 3 plus 3. Isn't it? Now in short way, we can directly return as write x, write the first factor, that is minus 1. Again write x, write the second factor, that is minus 3, is equal to 0. This is the shortcut method of factoring. Now if x minus 1 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to 1. If x minus 3 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to 3. Therefore, the zeros are 1 and 3. Now, let me take alpha is equal to, let alpha is equal to 1 and beta is equal to 3. Now, sum of zeros alpha plus beta is equal to 1 plus 3, that is 4. 4 can be written as, here the coefficient of this polynomial is a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 8, c is equal to 6. These are the coefficients. We have to arrange this number as the coefficients. So 4 can be written as 8 by 2 because coefficient of x square is 2 here. So we have to write 2 in the denominator. 4 can be written as 8 by 2, 8 by 2 is 4, isn't it? Now, we need a minus also. So, minus 8 by 2, isn't it? Minus into minus becomes plus 8 by 2. And it can be written as minus 8 by 2, minus 8 divided by 2. Now, minus means minus 1. So, I am writing this as minus 1 into minus 8 divided by 2. Isn't it? Now, minus 1 into minus minus 1 into, what about minus 8? Coefficient of x. Coefficient of x divided by coefficient of x square, that is 2. This is it. We have to convert like this. Now, alpha beta is equal to product of the zeros. Product of zeros is here alpha beta is 1 into 3, that is 3, and the 3 can be cancelled. Here also we need 2 in the denominator, so it can be written as 6 by 2, and 6 is constant term divided by constant term divided by coefficient of x square. This way we can find the ratio between zeros and coefficients, isn't it? Now let me take another question. Here the coefficient of x square is 2. You will get somewhat complication. I will do one more question. P of x is equal to 6 of x square minus 3 minus 7x. Another question. And it can be written as 6x square, then minus 7x minus 3. First, write x square term, then x term, then constant term. That is the hierarchy, the sequence of the polynomial. Here we can factorize this polynomial as sum is equal to coefficient of x, that is minus 7. Product term, here product is 6 into minus 3, that is minus 18. The product is what? 6 into minus 3. Now, find the factors of 18. Here, 1 into 18, 2 into 9, 3 into 6. These are the factors of 18. Of these factors, only one factor satisfies these two conditions. Can we check? Here, 18 plus 1, 19, 18 minus 1, 17, so it is not. 9 plus 2, 11, 9 minus 2, 7, but we have minus 7, so 2 minus 9 is minus 7. 2 into minus 9 is minus 18. So, it will satisfy us both the conditions. So 2 plus minus 9, that is minus 7, and 2 into minus 9, that is minus 8. Therefore, here we cannot directly write the factors. Here 6x square, middle term is split up into 2x plus 2x minus 9x. 2x minus 9x minus 7x, isn't it? Minus 3. Now, from these two terms, we can take on 2x outside. 2x, then 3x. 2x, then we have 1. From these two terms, and minus 3 outside, then 3x minus 1. Now, 3x plus 1, not minus 1, plus 1. That is minus 10, minus 3 into 3x minus 9x minus 10 becomes negative, isn't it? Now 3x plus 1 is a factor, then 2x minus 3, another factor. To find the zero of this polynomial, p of x is equal to 0, which implies that 3x plus 1 is equal to 0, or 2x minus 3 is equal to 0. If 3x plus 1 is equal to 0, if 3x plus 1 is equal to 0, which implies that 3x is equal to minus 1, that is x is equal to minus 1 by 3. And if 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, which implies that 2x is equal to 3, or x is equal to 3 by 2. These are the zeros. Therefore, 3x plus 1 is equal to 0. 3x is equal to minus 1, 1 becomes minus 1 and x is equal to minus 1 by 3. And if 2x minus 3 is equal to 0, 2x is equal to 3, then x is equal to 3 by 2, isn't it? Now let alpha is equal to, alpha is positive 0, that is minus 1 by 3. And beta is equal to 3 by 2. Now sum of zeros, alpha plus beta is equal to minus 1 by 3 plus 3 by 2. Now cross multiply, minus 1 into 2 plus 3 into 3 divided by 3 into 2. So we get minus 2 plus 9 by 6, that is minus 1 into coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Here in this polynomial, here a is equal to 6, b is equal to minus 7, c is equal to 3. So minus 1 into coefficient of x is, we put from minus 1. Minus 1 into coefficient of x is minus 7 and coefficient of x square is 6, isn't it? Now we are going to find the product of zeros. Product of zeros is product of zeros. Is alpha beta. Alpha and beta. Alpha beta is minus 1 by 3 into 3 by 2. That is minus 1 by 6. Minus 1 by 6. Minus 3, not minus 1, minus 3 by 6, minus 3 by 6, minus 3, here c is minus 3, not 3, minus 3 is the constant term divided by x6 is coefficient of x square. This way, we can find the relationship between the zeros and coefficients of a quadratic polynomial, isn't it? Now one more thing. If we know the zeros of a polynomial, then how can we form a polynomial? Let us discuss. Suppose if 2 and 3 are zeros of a polynomial P of x, then alpha plus beta is equal to 2 by 3 is equal to 5, and alpha beta is equal to 2 into 3, that is 6. If we know the zeros of a polynomial, then we can find the sum and product of zeros. And how can we form a quadratic equation? Is x square equation is x square minus alpha plus beta in x plus alpha beta is equal to 0. That is x square minus sum of zeros in the x plus product of zeros is equal to 0, isn't it? We can use the formula x square minus sx plus p is equal to 0, where s is equal to alpha plus beta and p is equal to alpha beta. So the equation is x square minus alpha plus beta is 5. 5x plus alpha beta is 6 is equal to 0. Isn't it? If we know the zeros, then we can form an equation. If we know an equation, we can find its zeros. Okay? Let us check the zeros of this polynomial. Here, sum is equal to minus 5, product is equal to 6, factors of 6, 1 into 6, 2 into 3. Using this factor, minus 2 plus minus 3 minus 5, minus 2 into minus 3 is 6. So we can write as x minus 2 into x minus 3 is equal to 0. If x minus 2 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to 2, and if x of minus 3 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to 2. Therefore, the zeros are 2 and 3. Isn't it? That is, if we know the zeros of the polynomial, we can form the polynomial. If we have a polynomial, we can find its zeros, and using the zeros, we can make the relationship between zeros and coefficients, isn't it? We train writing a lot. We have to assignment of the other chain ready. We have to learn the commands like you know. We have to learn the section for the cubic polynomial the relation between zeros and division algorithm. That I will give in the next class. Okay.